In this video, we are going to see a sum which relates to issue of shares for cash in lump sum. So this sum is the 19th sum from the 12th standard Samacheer book. So this sum is about Abdul Limited. So Abdul Limited has issued 50,000 shares. So he has issued 50,000 shares of rupees 10 each. So the face value of the share is going to be 10 each, payable on application. So this entire 50,000 shares at rupees 10 each is payable only through application itself. That is, there is no split up of allotment or first and final call. During application itself, they have received the entire value of the total amount of shares issued. So you must pass journal entries for when shares issued at par. That is nothing but the receipt of share application. So when you are receiving the money in lump sum, what entry you give. So that is nothing but you are going to receive it through application process itself. So write down the application received entry. So the application received entry is going to be bank account data to share application. So that is going to be your entry for this particular transaction when it is being issued at par. So being shares issued at par. So now for the calculation, it is going to be how much of shares, 50,000 of shares into 10 rupees face value. The entire face value has been received. So the total amount is going to be 5 lakhs. So this is a very, very simple sum when it is given that the shares are being issued at par and the money is being received during application itself. Right, the second division of this is when the shares are issued at a premium of 3 rupees. So, shares issued at premium of 3 rupees. So, he's given you the premium value also. So, when you are receiving the money for the application, the premium is also being received. So, the same entry you are going to put, but there is a small change. This entire amount is going to go into the share capital directly. So, it's going to be bank account debtor to share premium account. And this is going to go directly. The share premium which we receive is going to go into the share capital. So I write share capital over here. This is exclusively for receiving the premium money. So we are going to put share capital and we are not going to take share application. Because they have not mentioned that the premium is being received when the application process is going on. So they are selling this premium separately at 3 rupees. So the amount of shares are going to be the same, 50,000 shares. So let me write 50,000 for all the three journal entries. That is all the three items in the journal entry. So now the bank is going to be left out. First let me fill up the premium. The premium is going to be 3 rupees and the share capital, that is the face value or the called up value, is the same 10. So now when you add up this two, my only debit bank will be coming into account, that is 13 rupees. Right, so 50,000 into 13 is 6,50,000. Or you can do this way, 50,000 into 3 is going to be 1,50,000. 50,000 into 10 is 5 lakhs. So when you add up 1,50,000 plus 5 lakhs, it's going to be 6,50,000. So this is nothing but being shares issued at premium.